It's 11:48.
No, thank God.
OMFG.
Shut up! Don't mess
it up! Stop! Stop!
Let me deal with it. Let me deal. Let me try. Hey guys, welcome back to Scream Queen Stream. I'm your host Jessica Cameron. You know Heather Dorff. She's behind the camera at this moment. She's not going to be behind the camera for the entire process because I am cooking, which means she's going to have a panic attack and have to go outside on her balcony and smoke a cigarette because she's not able to watch this. Today we have several special guests, the most important being Amanda, who is a talented photographer. You can check out her work at the link below. We'll tag it in the description box. You might hear a familiar voice and one of our favorite people in the entire world, the talented, beautiful, breathtakingly wonderful Monica Pett.
Hello.
Who's your favorite thing ever? And my dog is incredibly jealous of.
Yeah, apparently Solomon doesn't like me a whole lot.
No. He's just jealous and opinionated. So what are we making today, Amanda?
We are going to make Whole 30 and I think keto as well, egg muffin cups, which are delicious, perfect, great for brunch, great for breakfast, great for late at night, super easy. When you're making this dish, these egg cups, you want to have everything ready to go because that's the whole key to being easy, because this is about simplicity, right?
Mm-hmm. Apparently, according to the recipe.
Oh, preheat the oven to 350, please.
Night, Jess can do it. Let's see if Jess can do it. All right, come on, Jess. Ah, bitch.
Shut up. Don't interrupt me.
Mm-hmm. Do your thing.
One second, let me.
Fuck, it's 11:48.
No, thank God.
OMFG.
Shut up. Don't mess
it up. Stop. Stop.
Let me deal with it. Let me try.
Nope.
Let it try.
There you go. Start.
What did you say?
350. Start.
Done.
Actually, for the purpose of this exercise, let's put it up to 375.
375.
God damn it.
I have dark hands.
350.
350.
Okay. I was like, no, I just got it to 350. I don't.
Wait. You got muffin pans, though, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, so no, she has regular muffin pans. Fair enough.
I'm just trying to cause you not to have to clean so much.
She actually got muffin pans.
Options, not issues.
So Amanda is cutting the vegetables.
I'm cutting the vegetables.
The peppers, the green onions, and the tomatoes. And I got grape tomatoes, not cherry tomatoes, which apparently are close to the same.
You can do whatever kind of tomato you want. You can do a Roma tomato, you can do a beefsteak tomato.
So we're making, this is a Whole 30 compliant ketogenic egg cup.
Yes. What it is it's an egg cup. It's basically a frittata, but it's in
a single
muffin
serving size.
You can make all of them on Sunday, put them in your refrigerator, and heat them up all week.
Which I love.
If you might like to smoke the Pocky Lolo, they're great for late night.
I don't know what that is.
It's marijuana, Jessica.
I don't do that.
She doesn't do that either.
Some of us have medical conditions where we might need a little Pocky Lolo.
I have a medical condition. It requires vodka.
Yes, I've known that for many, many years. Okay, so then I'd have to clean it up.
Because you fancy. It's not how we are.
No, it's not. Bowl. And I want to get done cutting so I can have a sip of vodka. Okay, so.
Or a chug of vodka. But we have a bowl. It's clean.
All right, so. Is the oil heating in the pan?
The oil's not.
Negative.
I have to let the pan heat first.
Like, how much oil? Just like
dollop? Like it's. You don't do it. You don't do things because I'm scared. 2 tablespoons? Did you say?
Yeah, that's about it. So
I'm gonna pretend like I know what I'm doing. I'm just gonna like move it around.
Shut up! I'm rotating the oil. As Danny is.
The pan
I don't particularly approve of this, but this prosciutto is cooked.
I'm sorry. Crossing.
We're going to add the prosciutto to the ham cups. Normally I would toast this in a pan, but we're going to add the prosciutto because it's already cooked, which is Whole 30 compliant as long as it just has cured with salt and water. So we're going to cut up a couple pieces of this.
By the way, our favorite ginger is in the background.
Throwing ice.
Well, I had to break it up.
Where the hell is my drink? Where's my drink?
Okay.
That's what the question everyone's asking.
Really? Where did my naked bitch go, though?
There's
like a net. Why do you have
I'm
my naked bitch?
It.
All right.
Where do you have my naked bitch? If that's what you said.
I'm getting you more.
very pretty.
Thank you.
I'm not filming anymore.
You
but
did
it's very
chop
pretty.
That really fast. I'll give you that much.
Me,
that was
much better
yeah.
than I did. Was. I cook all day, every day. On 12:30, you have to cook. It's like.
What the hell is Whole 30? Everyone's talking about this. I have no
Amanda,
idea what this
would
is.
You like to share what Whole 30 is? Whole 30 is a 30-day elimination plan of everything that might make you sick. No dairy, no gluten.
Also, it's everything delicious.
No rice, no grain.
Everything delicious.
No tofu, no sugars unless they
no
come
tofu.
From citrus or fruit juice that you have to juice yourself for the most part. Nothing preserved. So you basically clear your entire body out and then you slowly re-add things to figure out what makes you sick.
What's
does dairy make you sick? Does gluten make you sick?
Does
what makes
make
you
happy?
Well,
so this is for people that are consistently sick then?
It's not for people. I wasn't consistently sick.
Everyone who wants
sick.
To be super healthy.
I wasn't consistently
I love this microphone. It's so useful.
I'm trying to get done with a knife.
Sorry.
I wasn't consistently sick. I just didn't feel good for a really long time, and I was really heavy. And now I do it about every 3 months. I've lost about 65 pounds again.
Yes,
yeah.
Yeah.
I feel 20 years younger, and the most, I poop better.
Mm-hmm.
I have better skin. I have energy all the time. But the most important thing for me personally is I eliminated anything with processed sugar and I no longer have anxiety attacks. I haven't taken Xanax in almost 7 months.
Like even
and I was, no.
Yeah,
okay, well maybe the other night, but that's not I literally have not had an anxiety attack and I was having panic attacks. You can ask the lovely Monique. I was having panic attacks about, what, 4 times a week?
Yeah.
5 times a week? Never anymore. As long as it's just eating clean. It's
and
no chemicals. It's
and I researched it and I was like, this is a really great idea for somebody who needs to reset their diet.
Yeah.
When I was looking for something I wanted to do, I didn't feel like I was that far off kilter because I was more like, I just wanted to like reset a little bit.
No, and I think keto is great. And I may actually transfer over to keto because I'm going to New Orleans
keto.
In about 6 months.
Oh,
and
yeah,
I know
yeah.
I'm going to eat my entire body weight in bread and oysters. So
you can't eat bread.
So well, I will
yeah,
in New Orleans.
Yeah, you should. Just a moment.
So I think that I eventually may transfer over. Oh, lower that. I may transfer over to the keto just in a few months, just to add a few more things into my diet.
Well, and so I love keto because I feel like it's just so easy, especially when you're like out and about.
Is there a fan?
Yeah. That's exactly right.
But then we have to talk really loud.
That's really good sound quality.
Well,
yeah.
It's boring.
All right, well, when are we throwing shit in there? You're still hanging right now.
I'm going to stop.
I'm
going to
do it in just a little bit.
You guys are excited.
We're going to take half a lemon.
We should get the grain.
We're
going to
cut
first,
around it because this is hot. That's what Heather just said. She's directing.
I know, but that can wait a hot second.
No,
it's
burning.
In the oven, no?
There's trying to burn.
Okay, so this is the most easiest thing in the world.
Okay.
All you have to do, throw your green onions right in the pan.
Green beans,
right?
Sorry.
Okay. Watch out, stand back. Ooh.
Hot.
They're fucking angry.
That's oil.
It's
that's
angry.
Real hot oil is what that is.
And once it starts to pucker down, you're going to add a half a lemon.
Nice.
You can add some salt and pepper if you want. That's all you have to do.
I really do want to. Where's your salt pepper drawer?
That's shitty
okay,
fucking give me
that
salt.
Correct.
Give me that salt. Give me that salt, please. So then you're going to take a little bit of salt. Throw it in there.
Those are going to be salty.
Mm-hmm. Yes!
I'm getting all the lemon in.
She said half.
That was in half.
No, knowing you, you're going to pour so much in.
So this is this the heat when trying to heat up a little bit? Because you want to get them nice and brown. Because green beans, I'm sorry, are delicious.
I feel like we need more green beans for like all of us. They're like the
chill
okay.
girl. So
I don't have a chill button. It's like not in me at all. The ginger behind the scenes is laughing right now. She's like dying. Although, also noted, Monique, with like the close-up of the food,
obviously the pro YouTuber.
Gotta get the B-roll. Look, check out B-roll.
Right?
B-roll, yes. Go in there. Shake it up. I want to get that movement.
Pop your wrist.
Here.
There you go. Now, no, don't take it too long off the. Oh. There you go.
Okay, so now we need the bowl.
I have a bowl here.
Clean the bowl.
See, okay, 2 seconds of that is going to look like a real cooking video.
All right, now leave it alone, Jess. Leave it alone. Let the heat.
Yeah, just let them cook.
Yep.
I do this every morning, I swear to God.
I just cook enough to where I'm like, bitch, what you doing?
Yeah, I don't want to eat any of these. I just want them to cook. Okay.
No, you get one right now.
I'm hungry.
Well, we have to cook it first now.
Heather, you should be getting this.
Okay, so we're gonna do eggs. I'm actually really good at cracking eggs.
Oh, you want a
crack
egg?
Yeah.
Can you
do
a crack egg Michelle in it?
Yeah. How many do I need to
do?
We're gonna do
a lot.
I love your sense of control.
Can I put them in the other door?
Stir them around.
Can I have eggshells in your garbage disposal?
Yes. I mean, legally, no. But
you do all the
eggs. Let's get.
Legally, based on my HOAs, yeah, no, but.
All right, so Jess is cracking the eggs. And then,
Jess, be careful. Do not get eggshells in there.
No, she's,
She's doing it.
I'm going to check
her. She's doing it with flair. She's doing it with flair.
But the flair ends up in eggshells in her shit.
I'm going to check it.
It's good so far.
No, I'm good. I can actually do this. This is like the one thing I can do well.
This is Whole30 compliant non-stick for your pan. It's ghee. It's clarified butter cooking spray. I'm watching them. Don't panic.
Okay.
You have no idea how much I cook in a day. That's so your egg muffins don't stick. Perfect. Now you have the oven set at 350.
Yes.
375, you want that to be heated. And when the lovely Jessica Cameron.
Don't look, it's fine.
How many eggs is that, Jess?
I'm going on my eighth.
Do two more just to be safe. If we have to, we overdo it.
Done.
Calmed her down.
Yeah.
Until she gets that peanut butter fluff.
Mm-hmm. Oh my God, and I'll be so excited.
I'm going in.
Huh?
I'm going in.
You're going in? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
The green beans you can just let sit. I'm actually going to up the heat on them a little bit.
You think so? Really?
Because mm-hmm. you want them brown.
Ten.
You want them to be a little charred.
Okay.
Yeah. I've got 10.
So now you're going to take your whisk.
Oh, I'm whisking.
This is no. I'm gonna miss. But you're gonna watch. You're gonna help.
I'll be enthusiastically cheering.
We're gonna check for eggshells.
Yep. Okay.
Hello. I can make sure there's no eggshells.
Can you open the can of coconut milk?
Oh my God! I totally can't. Heather Dark, where's the can opener?
Theoretically, fuck. Theoretically, should be in here.
No,
okay.
I
was
gonna say. You let her use the beater,
I stepped in.
Okay. Don't make me feel bad, Danny. Okay, I have the coke.
Hold on to it.
Jess, you can't. When you do that, it's going to drop. All right.
No, it's fine.
No, it will literally drop. It will literally drop.
It's fine.
You see, if I wasn't holding it, it would have literally
dropped. No, it would not. Let go.
No, knowing your dumb bitch ass, you just. Stop! Stop!
This is like cooking with my ex-husband's family. Okay? And they weren't from America. Okay, so.
No! Just turn this on and do this. See how easy it is? All right.
On Whole30,
I got this,
Jessica.
Look at the cleaner
that. On Whole30, you can't use dairy, right?
Right.
Like so you can't on keto.
Maybe. Oh, right? No, we can't. We can use as much as we want
to. This is coconut milk.
Yeah,
so you're going to add about a quarter can of the coconut milk.
And you're estimating. I love that.
Well, I
she can.
Well, also, no,
you
no,
shouldn't.
The recipe called for 8, and you had me put in 10 eggs, so you might need to put a little bit more.
Well, I guess.
Okay,
yes.
Did you put in a little more then?
Well, I got to break up this other yolk first, or I'm going to fucking beat the shit out of somebody. Okay, so we're going to add a tad more.
A little bit more. I mean,
I'm watching it. Don't panic. You want to get this nice and brown.
I'll like the whole corner of them. Look at this. I can do stuff.
No, don't move them too much because then they don't cook.
Are you listening to me? I'm trying to teach you something.
Oh, sorry, Monique.
That's
there's
enough,
Jess.
There's
three seasonings. You could put in salt and pepper as well, but there's three seasonings that go great in this. Garlic powder.
Love garlic powder.
Mustard, which is amazing, and everyone should be using it because it adds flavor to everything.
Did you get that, or did I have?
I brought.
Okay.
And celery salt.
I have all.
So you're gonna add a sprinkle to your liking.
Like, I feel like we're excessive
celery
bitches here.
I love
celery
salt.
Just be excessive.
Girl, if this is what you're eating for days, you want it to be good.
Yeah.
You're gonna put in with garlic
salt. Be excessive.
Jess has an on. She likes adding so much seasoning. It's ridiculous.
I do. I'm a saucy bitch.
Options, not issues. Okay, so then you're putting a little mustard because mustard rule. One thing I've learned eating without processed foods and chemicals is that mustard powder is the key to life.
I would like more garlic powder.
Not too much.
I'd like three genies to give me three wishes and send me to fucking...
Well, let me figure out how to make that happen.
Make me rich.
Hold on, and we need salt and pepper, right?
Send me a paradise.
Yeah, salt and pepper.
There you go.
Okay, black pepper. Black pepper.
Jess.
Where's salt?
This is wood, which is fine, but mostly you should not leave utensils in the pan.
I mean,
I'm just going to train you.
I did that. That was
her,
my fault.
For
where's
her, no.
Oh, the salt is here. Okay, now.
You know that you never pour this directly into a...
I did not know that.
You put it in your hand first.
I usually like just throw that shit in that bitch.
Yeah.
That's why your feet get swollen.
Mm-hmm.
You don't want swollen feet.
My feet don't get swollen.
Look how cute your shoes are. Do you want swollen feet?
No, I don't. That would be tragic.
Well, then there you go. Did you drop the can top in the coconut milk?
She did.
Maybe. Oh,
Jesus Christ. On a scale of 1 to 10, it would be a yes.
She wasn't holding it, correct?
So this is... what it looks like. It's your typical scrambled egg mixture.
Sure.
This is the easiest thing in the world.
I know, right? I'm trying to pick one out, but you know, there's like...
You do this on a Sunday morning. You don't
prosciutto
do this for the rest
then?
Of the week. So you're going to throw in your prosciutto. I use 3 slices of prosciutto for 10 eggs. You can put it however you want it, as long as your protein outweighs your veg. So I'm putting in tomatoes. You're falling off the thing. Tomatoes, bell pepper, green onions, and you can add whatever you want to this. So whatever you have left over from your week, you can put in asparagus, you can put in broccoli, you can put in whatever you want. You can put in Jessica's fingers if you want.
Or like more black pepper.
Just stop. Give me the fucking thing.
Okay. So that's it. That's all there is to it. Literally. Now, if you're doing keto, you can put in cheese, right? Because you can have dairy.
Yeah, we can probably have dairy.
So you put cheese in if you're doing keto.
Keto. Whatever.
Keto. Options, not issues.
Oh my god, there's so many cameras. Okay. Let me check my close-up.
How's this close-up?
Yeah, that's the close-up I want every day.
I like that. So now you're going to take your heated, well,
it's not heated. But it's
not heated.
You're going to take your sprayed pan. Well, okay. This isn't really optional, but it does have a spout on it. And you're going to film about 3/4 of the way through.
Because they're going to expand.
Yes. That's how cooking works.
I did that one a little high.
I mean, sometimes.
Stir that, Jessica.
No, not sometimes. Always.
I'm supposed to stir something? Okay. What am I stirring?
The green beans.
You stir them a little bit.
I did.
They're burning.
We're good. No. They're good. They're good. Dork. Trust me.
Yeah, that one's on the
Jessica
side.
Jessica is channeling Betty Draper right now. And I'm channeling Dawn Draper circa 1970. Okay, so you just want something easy that you can...
Oh, it looks really pretty.
Yeah,
they're so
you want something colorful if you have to look at this. You know, if you're using this every morning for breakfast. Now, I may have overestimated the amount of the egg a little. So we have a little leftover, which, if you have
just
a little bit more.
Just fill this one
there,
a little bit more.
If you have a little leftover, you can always throw in a pan and scramble.
Just go ahead.
Yeah, you can
just go ahead and fill them all. High, they'll just go over. All right, that's fine.
So you can throw this in a pan and your leftovers and scramble it, and you have breakfast while you're cooking this. And now we're gonna pop these in the oven at 350.
For how long?
I'll open the oven.
It's usually about 15 to 20 minutes.
I'm gonna do 15, let me check, and then turn.
Sorry. Middle rack.
Yep.
For those of you who are lucky to have 3 racks, Heather Dorf.
Oh, what? I had the fucking owner install a new stove because the other stove was shit.
And this is about where your green beans should be right now. You want them to cook for about another 3 minutes. I'm sorry, I got oil all over your stove.
I don't care, it's okay.
She's never here, it's fine.
Yeah, true that.
You can do more green beans than this. I'm just doing a small amount.
Also, the best part is just having a man to do it.
That's how I feel.
All right, so we're just going to let this cook. And then when it comes out...
You don't think they're... I smell burnt.
No, they're not burning.
You're imagining things at their door.
Give them like another minute and okay. It'll be perfect.
But we should get... Well, no, we can like cook the leftover egg in this pan. When we take out the green beans, right?
Yeah, green beans.
Well... Let's take this out of this.
We can stop these now. You guys don't
Let's stop them. Okay. Not too burnt. I don't like too burnt. Carcinogens are not good.
Thank you. There's no
carcinogen. What the fuck is a carcinogen? Can you
anytime
spell that?
All that sugar.
Anytime anything gets black, it's
Did
carcinogen.
You put the...
Let's not judge.
All right, so these are done.
We're not judging.
We're not judging. We're not
we
doing
don't
that.
Judge.
How are they? Do they taste okay?
They're delicious. Mm.
That's right.
I've been eating all day, so of course they're delicious.
All right, so we can let this sit. Do you want to scramble those?
She wants to scramble the eggs.
All right, so let's put these on.
Do you want to take them out then?
Yeah, we can take them out. I like them a little more well done just because it gives them a little more flavor, but that's all you. So up to you guys. Are you going to let Jessica scramble these eggs?
Yes. Sure. Maybe. Jess, put all these on the plate.
Don't drink that coconut milk because
that'll be magical.
All right, Jess, when you're scrambling eggs, you have to literally move them.
So are you saying?
Hi. Jess. Be reasonable. All right, here, we're good?
No, we have one more. All right,
more. Here we go. Now, here. We're gonna do this. Ready?
Yeah.
Alright, wait. Nope, don't move. Don't move yet.
I want this one. I want this guy.
That's fine. Give it a second.
You've been so busy. I've been eating and she's starting.
Alright. Start moving. Moving from the sides
well,
first. Sides off, in. Sides in. Oh, we turned it off? Oh, that's not good. Medium.
I turned it off.
Medium. No, move from the sides in. Sides in, sides in. There you go. Sides in, sides in. There you go. When you see it getting white, move it. All right.
Let it rest.
Now let it rest. Only white. You need to move.
Don't worry, Betty Draper.
White in, white in. You see those sides, those edges? This edge here? Need that. That shit will burn. There you go. All right. Now spread it all out thinly throughout the pan. You're not gonna need much more because the pan's already real hot. You don't want to overcook.
No, I. You can only give up one thing at a time.
You're near the end here because you don't want to overcook. At the end of the day, this pan's so hot. Smells good. Ooh, it smells real good.
Look at that! Is this like technically
you're
a scramble?
Pretty much, you're good. I mean, you're good. Yeah, yeah. No, that is a strip. You're doing it right. You're doing it right. You're in
stage
right.
Scramble that. All
right. I don't want you to cook it anymore. Go ahead.
She like cut me off.
Nope, you're done. Go ahead and dump that out.
On what? Where?
On a plate. All right, wait. Here we go.
Here's your magic wand. Here's how you know they're done. You stick a knife in them. They're gonna go concave, but if you can stick a knife in them and
no
nothing
comes
out, they're done.
Yep.
So you're gonna do a little, I think these are gonna be a little bit overdone. You go around the edges.
I'd rather have overdone than underdone.
It's not eight. Heather's fault. Stop blaming Heather.
It's always Heather's fault.
I don't know anything about this, and they looked real underdone.
They're not underdone now.
No, 100% no.
Girl, that's a real issue of mine.
You rather have a little bit overdone than underdone when it comes to egg.
We gotta let them cool for a few minutes.
Solomon, get Solomon.
Hi, Solomon.
Mm. He's ridiculous.
Is he not the cutest dog in the world? I mean, he's the cutest dog in the world.
Who's your auntie? Who loves you? Auntie loves you. You scared him away. It's fine. Auntie loves you when she has ham.
Or prosciutto. Can you say prosciutto?
All right, so we're going to let these sit for a couple minutes before I pull them out. I'm afraid they're going to stick.
You don't think they'll overcook if you let them sit?
It doesn't matter if they overcook because they're baked. These are really good when you put cheese in them, but unfortunately, they won't come out yet. If you try to take one out too soon.
Try though. I think they're actually done. They're so bouncy, I think they're done. Yeah.
Who knew?
Dorps.
I like Heather. Don't be mean to Heather. Heather and I just met, and I like her. And now you're going to make us not be friends.
I'm not being mean, but we should grab that extra little bit of egg.
Go ahead. Take your spatulas and get that little bit of extra egg.
Get the other ones out, though, because they'll overcook.
I know, but more she's got to get in there.
Egg.
I can't.
Just save your knife.
So these, once you take them out, once they cool, you can pop them in a Tupperware for your whole week. So if you're hungry, if you're having people over for brunch, you can make them the day before or whatever, and you just reheat them.
How do you reheat them?
Put them in the microwave for about 30 seconds on high, and they'll just reheat. So you can take them to work, you can take them to a brunch, you can... get high and eat them at 1 o'clock in the morning. Your friend can take away the plate and she's gonna eat them all. And they go delicious with the green beans that we cooked earlier. And I suppose they'll go delicious for dessert with the peanut butter fluff. I don't wanna eat, everybody else eat.
Why aren't you eating?
Because I cooked it. That's my thing.
I'm the same way. I'll eat. It's hard to cook.
What? Did you cook it or did I cook it?
Who cooked it?
You cooked it. It's all you. Where's dessert, by the way?
Probably in the freezer.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You left it in the fucking freezer. Shut up. It's better than on the floor.
The rest of everything.
They're pretty good, right?
It fell on the floor. Okay.
Can we go in?
Do we eat with our hands?
Yeah,
eat away.
Eat with your hands. I don't know. That's what I did.
All right, I'm gonna try this green bean right here.
They're little muffins. Of course
I'm gonna take one of the floor muffins. The muffins that fell on the floor because I'm classy like that.
It's good, right?
They're really good.
There's no cheese. Mm.
Jessica, how do you feel about the green beans?
Oh my God, they're so good. I ate half of them before we started.
Mm-hmm. Okay, eggs. These egg things are really good. They're actually not overcooked.
They're actually really good.
They're not
really
overcooked good at all. Not at all.
Egg muffins?
Yeah.
Egg and magic nice muffins. Breakfast.
Now you can heat these up.
Yeah, uh-huh.
You can. Wife makes a snack. Like late night snack.
Exactly.
Protein.
When you heat them up, you throw them in the microwave for 30 seconds straight out of the refrigerator. So you can make a ton of them on the weekend or whatever your day off is. And then you have them for the week.
Yeah.
They're delicious.
I love them.
Right? And you can put whatever you want in them. So you can put broccoli in them. You can put straight onion in them, sweet onion.
Does anyone else think they're overcooked? Overcooked is
no, I think they're delicious.
I think they're perfect.
Like, I would say they could use cheese.
Everything keto could use cheese. It.
Well, your heart's better for it.
But he does like green beans.
Like Java bean.
Beans. Can we just take a moment to talk about those green beans? They are amazing.
They are amazing.
You would know because you ate fucking all of them.
I did.
Who didn't?
I had like four green beans.
Who didn't know what green beans were
at the beginning of the night?
But they're so. By the way, they taste like a potato chip.
Little lemon, salt and pepper, olive oil. Get them browned up.
It's like a potato chip.
And salt and pepper.
It's like a potato chip for your heart. You were drinking mine.
Mine's here.
Fine.
Oh, I was! No, I told you. Like, it's yours. It's pink. I'm used to pink.
Here,
I'm gonna get everybody's drinks.
What?
Wait, and while you're up, why don't you get that bowl of fluff?
It's in the freezer.
And
it's
in the freezer. Bowl. We need food. Hold on.
I'm not. I have nothing to do with any of this. I don't know what she's doing.
Except I love her.
Alright.
I love you.
Aww.
Yeah, we're the gingers.
See?
The ginger.
We're the ginger.
That's good protein.
Us girls get along. We do. Isn't it nice to have a bunch of ladies getting along?
I don't understand when girls don't get along with other girls.
What is up with that?
It's competition.
Women should support each other.
Yes, people out.
I was not in
You were not in frame.
I told you I wasn't in frame. I told you.
It's total. You know what? I read a thing recently that said that 90% of women put on makeup not for men, but other women.
But for themselves and for other women.
And we need to stop that because.
And I did my makeup for you bitches tonight.
Yeah, that is gorgeous. I love you.
Did you also get in?
True.
Yes. Yeah, this
we have
peanut
butter fluff.
Oh God.
With sugar-free.
I'm still eating eggs.
I mean, like technicality.
I love you, but
I can't eat it. You're not allowed. Just you're not allowed.
This is
hold
not
on. Don't drop the bowl.
I'm
don't
not
drop
holding
the bowl.
It.
I need a napkin.
It's fine. I'll be the fucking trooper.
Actually, I don't care.
I kind of killed it. This is fucking great.
I'm gonna go for the eggs.
I'm sure it works, butt cancer.
I'm gonna do eggs because
this is delicious.
Eggs is healthy.
I'm sorry. This is so
I'm
good.
So jealous.
I'm sure it is.
It's so good.
There's dairy in that, right?
No
dairy in that.
Nice
it looks
dairy.
Yummy though. But
you don't eat dairy either.
I can't.
Word edge.
Apparently, I'm the only person here who doesn't fucking diet.
but also, side note, it's fucking delicious. Oh my God.
It's like peanut butter ice cream.
Well, and that's the thing. Like, it's not because I'm like, oh my God, I'm dieting. No, it's because dairy fucking hates my face.
I'm so glad dairy doesn't.
I love your face.
I love
Indian
your face.
Indian food
and
hates
I'm
my face.
And I'm non-dairy.
Yeah.
Like, Indian food, I regret it for a week. But dairy
can handle. Well, dairy does that to me. And the important thing is, the thing that works for you doesn't work for you.
Exactly.
Doesn't work for you, doesn't work for me, but works for you.
All different.
Sort of. But, you know, we're all individuals. We all have to do
we
what
all have
works
our different
for
things.
Us.
Well, heavy cream always works for me. It's just later when I can't put my shorts on that
can
it doesn't.
I just, like, get Heather dropped those?
All right, I am going to try a bite of this.
It's awesome. It's awesome.
Okay, I will try.
I made this with a man. It's amazing. This is good shit.
Jessica Cameron, I'm going to do this. I'm going to take a little. Okay. I'm sorry. I apologize to everyone.
I can taste the fact that fake sweetener was used, but it's not.
Yeah.
It's not.
Offensive.
It's not extremely offensive. No.
You know what the best part about this is? The fact that we're all eating out of the same damn bowl.
I don't care.
Because we love each other. No, that's not like it.
Because you guys are my bitches. You're my dogs.
Because we're friends.
Ride
right
or die, bitches.
Yes, ride or die.
No, I'll tell you, I'm the first person to go, I'm against artificial sweeteners, but this doesn't taste bad.
It's not bad.
No.
The peanut butter helps.
The peanut butter.
Peanut butter helps.
Master.
I would, if I was going to do this a little healthier, I would go with maybe an almond butter.
Mm-hmm. 100%
I would go with
butter.
An almond butter, and I would go with a different sweetener, maybe a carob sweetener, just to make it Whole30,
mm-hmm.
but a sweetened carob, I don't think that's really Whole30, but... You can make this a little bit
I'm
more.
For the eggs.
Go for the eggs.
The eggs are actually really good.
I had two of them.
Mm-hmm. Y'all want
to
touch
could, like,
my boobs?
We could, like, advertise this as a mukbang, and we would not be lying. I love that.
Well, yeah.
Here's the thing.
Everyone wants to touch my boobs.
Chris are too much against. This is against fat and, like, protein. It's, like, you need both those things. Like, so much.
So
like,
much, yeah.
Sugar is honestly the devil.
Oh my God, there's
which is your favorite
thing
is the only
world.
Thing, unless it's like
sugar
from natural,
meat.
Like,
but that's also Heather Dorff's like secret to life.
It is, I eat a lot of sugar.
I eat Jenny sugar. Was like, will Heather Dorff like this? And I was like, doesn't have a lot of ridiculous amounts of sugar.
Sugar,
in it.
No.
Like, yes, that.
But
like, yes,
that's the scent. But to be fair, sugar's addictive. It's like a drug. Sugar is.
Oh my God, kicking sugar last week. Can I tell a little story?
Mm-hmm.
Go for it.
Yeah. Okay.
My husband came home from work, and it was my fourth day off sugar. And all he said to me was, do you need me to take out the trash? And I turned around to him and said, I literally did this.
Take it out before I have to.
I went completely insane. It literally
your head started spinning around.
My head went to a place.
Spinning.
And he's like, I didn't do anything. What's wrong with you? And I'm like, nothing's wrong with me. Get the It was horrible, and my poor husband went through 3 goddamn days of it. And that's why I don't. Yes,
bless his heart.
I don't want to do it again because
sugar is literally a drug. I'm not kidding.
It
really is. It's an addiction.
And I never knew it until I did the whole 30.
I ain't even ready.
Until you had to get yourself off of it, you're like, fuck.
I even like other women better, which is a thing because you know we don't always all get along. But you know, it's like once I'm off of it, I'm off of it. So. Thank you, ladies, for trying my experimental, well, my muffins, which I make, but they're a little...
They're yummy. They're super yummy.
They're very good.
They're like little perfect breakfast omelets.
They are. Mm-hmm.
And thank you, Jessica, for making this lovely dessert and scaring the living fucking shit out of me.
I will say, I'm not a fan of artificial sweeteners, though.
But I won't eat them. I did take a little taste because, you know...
In my personal opinion, if you have to go between natural... chemical, go natural, in my opinion.
But that's still delicious.
It's good, but it's scary.
She's like, if you're going to drink soda, drink the real shit. You might as well.
Drink the shit with sugar versus chemicals and stuff. It sounds weird, but it's fucking
scary. Get stuff with sugar alcohol. It looks better.
Which is why I don't really drink soda in general. But like, if I'm going to, I'm just going to drink the real shit as opposed to like...
All things in moderation. At the end of the day, the problem is America does not live in moderation. We don't live in moderation.
No.
Don't start me.
That's the thing. Anything's fine in moderation.
If you look at Europeans and how healthy they are and how long they live, or Eastern, you know what I'm saying? And the difference is the moderation.
A little bit of everything.
Moderation. They do not.
Options.
Everything's
we know. I think as Americans, me growing up fully in 1970s with like. When I would see the dots on the Wonder Bread label and Peter Pan on the Peter Pan thing, everything to me was advertising. And as I've gotten older, take a minute to explore it. It just takes a second. Put on the glasses if you have to. Read what's in it. When you start reading how many chemicals are in things and how many sugars and sweeteners, when something says sugar-free...
No
offense,
but
Jessica.
When something says sugar-free,
that just means it's more chemical. Fat-free
is the worst.
I'll never forget.
Go for fat before you go for fat-free. I'm not even fucking kidding.
The time I got,
I'm not even kidding.
100%.
Go for the fat. Do not go for fat-free.
Have you ever gotten fat-free cheese, like a slice of fat-free cheese, and you try to make a grilled cheese and it never melts? You can have it in the broiler on high. This close to the fire and it doesn't melt. That's an issue.
It's not real.
All I'm saying is, look at that. Look at that.
The thing is,
look at it.
No, it's just like my mom raised me in the 90s where they told them that like margarine and all of these things with the trans fat was better for us.
Did you just say you grew up in the 90s?
I did grow up in the 90s.
Fucking millennial. Can we hit her?
I am a millennial. I grew up in the 90s.
The only millennial I'm going to give a pass to. Because they actually told us that in the 70s. But my grandmother refused to believe it. So she did butter. And in the 80s, they believed butter. In the 90s, we started to believe that butter was better. But
my mom, unfortunately, my mom fell for all that bullshit. And she gave me totally trans fat.
You were born in the 90s?
I was born a little bit before the
90s. No, she was fucking born in the 80s.
But I grew up. I grew up in the late 80s.
But you're very pretty.
I grew up like when it mattered. My diet mattered.
She pretended to be introverted.
I am introverted, but I am a millennial, although I don't identify as a millennial.
Do you make soap?
Technically, if
you make soap and
do
you date guys with beards?
We're millennials.
No, neither.
No,
she's not a hipster, she's just a millennial.
No, but do you...
There's a big difference.
No, I'm not a millennial, I'm not a snowflake, I don't believe anything should be handed to me.
Thank you. Oh my God, I'm gonna French kiss you later.
No, I'm one of those millennials that's like weird.
You're a self-starting millennial is what you are.
I'm early millennial. I'm literally as early as you can get in the millennial phase.
Actually, January 1990?
1986?
No. 1986, what's your birthday?
September 22nd, 1986.
All right.
I'm literally the
You're
first
born the
right
same day as my grandmother, and I think
I'm
I might
right
love
on the
you
edge of being an ex. That's the thing. I'm right on the edge of being
You're
an
more
ex.
Than same really? Day as your grandmother.
But that's the thing. I don't identify as a millennial because I don't fucking think like a millennial. I had
no,
floppy disks and I didn't even have it.
She's
you know,
got floppy.
No, I cassette players and
she
all that shit.
She got floppy disks.
I don't identify as millennial. Disc. I was not raised to believe things should be handed to me. I did not get rewards for being second place. Like, I didn't.
Oh my God.
Like, we weren't offered that. We lost. If you were first place, you lost. That's how that went.
Second is the first to lose, my friend.
Yes, it is. It's the
and
first
the
to lose.
And the words of my friend's mother, Lavanna fucking Harding, second is the first to lose. I was friends with Donnie. So.
That's literally how it went. It was like, good try.
Stop,
try
stop,
harder
stop,
next.
Stop. Stop.
Yeah.
You're friends with fucking...
Tonya?
Tonya Harding's mom?
I was friends with Tonya, so I knew her mom.
Oi!
Who taught you to...
Thank you so much for checking out Scream Queen Stream. We hope you loved it as much as we do.
If you want to see more of our videos, check out our YouTube page. And while you're there, how about you subscribe? You want to see more? Just tweet us. Find us on Facebook. Join in on the fun.
And most importantly, if you really want to join us on this crazy ride, check out our Patreon page and become a patron for amazing, awesome perks that we give out monthly.
As well as early access to all of our videos.
Free giveaways.
And a whole lot more fun shit.
So check it out.
We'll see you there.
Stay bloody.
You stole my tagline.
I did.
You're a horrible friend.